Welcome to Moving Forward with Uponor. I'm Daniel.
And I'm Marcus.
And we are here every Thursday to talk to you about all things Uponor, including plumbing, hydronics, and industry. And if you guys like this video, make sure you guys hit the like button, subscribe. You can actually post questions down below as well. And maybe we even try and work those into a segment in a future video. So we've talked about a lot in our kind of videos before this regarding kind of how we got here, moving to commercial, different piping fitting solutions. What are we going to talk about today?
Well, today I want to talk about different methods, best practices for PEX pipe supports and hangers specifically too. How our product, whether it be the HeatPEX for mechanical applications or the AquaPEX for potable water applications, I think it'd be important too to really talk about and show what can be done to make sure that our pipe is straight and crisp. What also is important too to know with different hangers.
Yep, so we'll hit on some things regarding support spacing, code versus manufacturer. We'll obviously talk about aesthetics is a big thing with PEX in general. And our focus is primarily gonna be on commercial, right? If you guys are interested in hearing about some of the small diameter stuff, we can have a future video on that. Lots of cool stuff out there for small diameter PEX supports. That are tons of different manufacturers make. I know Marcus has one option here that we'll just show that's typical for wood frame, but there's obviously a lot of cool stuff out there too for steel and concrete.
Yeah, so like we mentioned, today we want to talk commercial, and you know we want to focus on, because we do get a lot of questions around those larger diameter sizes that we see starting around the 1 1/4 up to 3 inch sizes. But you know, obviously there is 1/2 inch and 3/4 inch on commercial projects as well. So we've seen a lot in kind of the wood frame or stick frame type construction, as we've seen tube talons is a common application for hangers or supports, where they just will nail it to the stud, the joist, or the floor. Another one too that you've seen quite often is in kind of a PT application or steel decking is a different type of support.
Right, so as Marcus mentioned with PT deck or post tension, there's a couple different ways you can go about it, and a lot of it is similar to how you would support large diameter pipe. It's just with, I guess, smaller clamps and smaller supports, but really there's kind of two ways you go about it. Either you're, you know, suspending the piping down lower with clamps and, you know, clevis hangers, loops, that kind of stuff, or strut, or the other option is keeping it up tight to the bottom of the concrete deck if you have that option. And there's some really cool different brackets out there with grommets that are made by some different manufacturers that basically just get shot up into the bottom of the deck and actually allow you to kind of nicely take and, you know, follow a nice contour with your small diameter piping.
So let's talk about the big pipe. You know, on the table in front of us is the 1 1/2 size here. You know, let's talk about some best practices and walk through some of the hangers.
Right. Yeah, so one of the first things we'll talk about is just the pipe physically itself, right? So one thing to keep in mind is that we manufacture all of our PEX with a copper tube size outside diameter. And the reason that's important is because it allows you to use copper tube size clamps and supports. And obviously that's really important when your product is basically out there trying to, you know, displace those materials from the field. It makes it easier for our customers to transition to our product. So anything from standard copper tube size riser clamps, right? Typically copper coated, so you don't have any galvanic issues there. To copper tube size strut clamps and copper tube size clevis hangers. And this one actually has an insulation donut, which we'll talk about in a little while as well.
And that's important too, because when you start getting into some larger sizes and other plastic polymer type piping systems, you know, things might get change a little if you're going from CTS or IPS and transition there, but it's important too to note that even from 1/2 inch up to 3 inch, Uponor ProPEX is all in CTS or copper tube size, because Uponor saw it was important to keep that that even field, that consistency in the field, knowing that there's a number of hanger options, insulation options out there.
Right. So let's transition over to the PEX-A pipe support product, right? So a lot of guys see this, right? And I think one of the biggest questions we get when we get a lot of cool installation photos from customers. So if you guys have those, make sure you send them in. But we'll post, you know, pictures on social media, and the view with the piping system is always kind of from below, right? And you get a lot of comments with guys saying, hey, why is there electrical conduit in your pictures?
That's right, yeah, exactly. So when you're still looking up on the floor, looking you know, from the floor up to a suspended assembly or piping system, guys will say, you know, that looks like metallic conduit, you know, galvanized conduit. It's like, well, that's not the case. It's a preformed PEX-A pipe support that creates the rigidity to our PEX-A piping system that really gives installers that clean, crisp look for it. So when they're doing runs, when they're doing turns and drops, so it looks professional. It gives it that clean look that, you know, that provides installers that pride. And it's almost an artwork when they're able to provide parallel lines and sharp turns with that. The PEX-A provides that opportunity.
Right. So let's talk. So first, let's talk about the physical product itself, right? So it's basically 23-gauge galvanized steel, comes in 9-foot lengths, and it's just over half round. And what's important about that is it actually snaps on kind of to the bottom of the pipe. And a secondary benefit, we'll talk about this, but a secondary benefit of it comes in the form of reducing expansion and contraction. But the primary benefit of it is to extend support spacing. So one of the biggest gripes against PEX has always been, especially as we moved into commercial, is that, hey, I have to support this stuff every 32 inches or 48 inches. And now that's not the case with this product.
That's right, because that PEX-A pipe support comes in 9-foot length. So really, and we can talk about that too, is you know, the difference between what code requires and what the manufacturer requires. These PEX-A pipe supports come in 9-foot lengths because now we're able to extend the length in between each support to 8 feet. So it does it, you know, whether it's hot water or cold water, we can have that extension there. So now by reducing the hanger and support counts, you're reducing that material, you're reducing that labor. And we've done the testing for that. I mean, we have you know, world-class testing facilities. We've done best practices and ability to control expansion and contraction at our facility.
Right, and like as Marcus is alluding to, we have a 200-foot test apparatus where we've been able to basically thermal cycle from all kinds of different crazy conditions, whether it be chilled water or super warm, you know, 200-degree water, with the PEX-A pipe support and test all kinds of different things. And what's cool about that is it's not just us selling a product now, it's also saying, hey, we have this product and these benefits, and we can prove that these benefits actually work. So we talked about the extended support spacing. We talked about expansion contraction a little bit, but maybe let's get into the weeds with that a little bit more.
Yeah, so let's talk about with that, the ability to control that expansion contraction. You know, with the PEX-A pipe support, you're creating an assembly. You're creating one piping system by joining the PEX-A pipe support to the tube strapped down, that it's creating that friction in there that really controls that movement of the pipe. So essentially, with that PEX-A pipe support, you're creating a situation that mimics or matches what copper tube expansion contraction is too.
Right.
You know, but at the same time, we're still able to extend our hanger support up to 8 feet.
Right. And in combination, obviously there's some things that you guys can check this out in our design manuals, but obviously along with the PEX-A pipe support, you know, there are some clamping requirements and some stuff regarding like fixed points and that kind of stuff. But you can find out some more information on that in our design manuals on uponor-usa.com. Let's transition a little bit over to vertical, right? So we talked about kind of horizontal piping, the PEX-A pipe support. Maybe let's hit on vertical a little bit.
Yeah, so with the vertical piping too, we have different, you know, solutions with that. There's the standard riser clamp here that on the floor of each riser, where also you might have to secure it to the top deck as well in that vertical piping requirements. But for Uponor PEX, it's requiring both at the floor and at the ceiling for different type of clamps and supports. And that's kind of goes to that difference is what does code require and what does the manufacturer require.
Right. And all this stuff, and one of the things that Marcus hit on there was this code versus manufacturer. And one of the ways we kind of help engineers, contractors, building owners out with that is through things like a PMG report through ICC. So it's a code document. So basically, if you get into a situation where you've used PEX-A pipe support, for example, to do extended support spacing, you can actually leverage a PMG report with an authority having jurisdiction and say, hey, Uponor's tested this, it's in the PMG report. All things are good to go.
So yeah, so with the other piping, you know, with just like the different piping systems, there's different insulation requirements as well, whether it's fiberglass or closed cell type insulation. And one thing too that's important with that is to note that insulation goes over this assembly. It goes over the pipe, goes over the PEX-A pipe support, and is insulated just like you would essentially any other type of piping system.
Yep. Yeah, and obviously we talked about the clamping, right? So in order for us to actually be able to fully get the benefits of the pipe support, reducing expansion and contraction, that obviously comes along with clamping. And obviously that means then the clamp has to be on the pipe, and then the insulation over the top of that. Now there are situations, right, with insulation where you can use the clamps like this or the donuts that are available both with strut clamps and with clevises, where the pipe will actually go through this, and this still does provide a bit of a clamping force as well as a place to you to be able to butt up the insulation to that.
Yep, and the great thing with those donut type clamps or the donut type inserts that you mentioned is that this really gives that opportunity to satisfy any type of specifications where they, you know, require continuous insulation. So the tube passes through the donut, the insulation pretty much butts up to it, providing that continuous insulation for that piping.
Yep. And then last but not least, before we get off the subject and kind of and close out this video, but the PEX-A pipe support actually is also E84 rated. So one of the cool things about the product is that we've tested it as an assembly with the pipe itself. So this is actually rated for use in return air plenums as an assembly like this. So also really cool additional feature as well.
Yep, and we have another video too that will go into fire rated construction, and we'll really hit on that. What does that ASTM E84 mean? What does that do to the rating being a manufacturer?
Right. Yeah, so make sure and check that video out. It's a fire resistant video. If you have any questions or comments, make sure to throw those down in the comment section below. And thanks again for watching.
Thank you.